Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing an overview of the World Tournament on the JP side of Dokkan. Now, apologies, I know, I did not actually get this video out on time to you guys. I completely forgot, like, I remembered it while I was at work, and I was like, crap, I never did the new World Tournament, the 24th World Tournament on JP. And then every time I got home, I'd be like, yeah, I gotta do that, then I would just fall asleep, and I'd completely forget the next morning. So, without further ado, we're going to go ahead and do that. This is going to be released actually today on Monday. This is when I'm doing it. It did end last night. If you're looking at my screen or your screen right now, the end date was actually Sunday night. So again, apologies for that, but I still want to go over it so that way it's at least available in the history. So it was started on 6/22, ran until 6/24. For those of you on Global, this should hopefully be out over the next couple tournaments, probably another 6 to 8 months. I don't know how it's going. It's all kind of crazy. Rewards will be distributed as of tonight/tomorrow, Pacific time, tomorrow's Pacific time, and summons are going to be available until 7:03, so you have some time. A whole bunch of good mission rewards here, some Dragonstones, some silver SSR tickets, Gravity Chamber, Sensu Beans, blah, blah, blah. I think the ones that everyone's really always worried about are the ones that you should get is the points. It's like 6.3 million all the way to 8.7 million. Now, I am doing the Global World Tournament that ends tonight. I'm only trying to get up to the 8.7 million. I might actually go to the 9 million, depending on what the actual rewards are on the global side. But I do want to try and get as many points as I possibly can, just so that way I can, you know, be solid there. It looks like here actually we got a whole bunch of other rewards. This is like 300 million points, maybe that is. I don't know. I have to wait and see. Maybe it's just 30 million points. Yeah, it's probably 30 million points. That makes more sense. So you have a whole bunch of cool stuff. It's pretty much the standard World Tournament items. I definitely highly recommend if you are a primary JP player to go at least until 8.7 million because you want to get those large potential orbs. I'm definitely, like I said, Global, I always at least do that, and that's probably what I'm going to end up doing in this World Tournament because I've been running errands all day and I do not want to grind out for 8 hours straight to try and place. Though the Mighty Mass does look damn pretty cool. In terms of the World Tournament reward, we do have the cell as you just saw on my screen. It's going to be the typical same ranking rewards up until the top 10,000. You get one cell. After 10,000, you do not. Or actually, this is 10 to 20,000, so they actually increased it. So now in the top 20,000, you get the new reward, which is actually pretty good. We needed that to happen for a long time. So that's finally a thing. But you get the cell, and then you get all the standard basic rewards. And it's pretty much just a whole bunch of either Elder Kai's guaranteed SSR tickets, Waking Metals training items and whatnot. So, you know, standard stuff. Local rewards, if you guys aren't familiar on the JP side, LR Piccolo was now replaced with LRTN, who is available. Dokkan Awakens it to this dude, who then Dokkan Awakens it to this dude. It's pretty cool. If you don't know, the Piccolo is available on the Dragon Ball Saga summons. So he is available, I believe. It's either the Dragon Ball Saga summons or the guaranteed SSRs, one of those two. But either way, he is available. So you can go ahead and try and grab him if you get lucky enough to do so, if you haven't grabbed him already. In terms of the cell, Margin of Transcendence cell perfect form. His leader abilities, tech type key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 50%. Super attack is Super Kamehameha. Greatly raises attack for one turn, causes supreme damage to the enemy. That's actually a really good passive on the super. Passive skill, Evil Provocation. Extreme class allies, key plus 2, and attack and defense plus 30%. Super class enemies, defense minus 50%. So he is a support unit who does a little bit better damage because of that passive skill, greatly raising attack. He's not bad. There are definitely better units that you could have, that you could run, but key plus 2, attack and defense plus 30% is actually pretty damn good. He's going to be really good for a villain's team. So those of you who placed, good for you, congratulations. For those of you in the future who summon on the banner, if he's available on these banners, then, you know, hell yeah, he's an awesome support unit. Link skills are Gentleman, Messenger from the Future, Big Bad Bosses, Kamehameha, Nightmare, and Ultimate Life Form. Max stats are HP of 81/16, Attack of 82/07, Defense of 45/32. Defense being a little bit higher for a technique unit, I guess maybe for the newer meta, it's about standard, about average. Attack's actually a little bit lower, and HP's a little bit lower, but it is a free-to-play World Tournament card. It's not really free-to-play, you gotta grind out for it, but he technically is free. So, he's pretty cool. His 12 key multiplier is 140%, and greatly raises attack for one turn is 50%. And you could farm out these Evolved Cell Perfect Forms to increase his super attack. This is Evolved Cell Perfect Form. He can Dokkan Awaken from Cell First Form Fusion, which is available from the Horrific Cell Games, which you're going to farm out from level 1 on Z-Hard. Yeah, I know, it's a whole bunch of stuff. The cool thing about him, Cell Perfect Form, he does, like, I'll show you right now, he links with other cells. So that's Cell Perfect Form, and you have Perfect Cell. So he will actually, I mean, I don't have a linking guide set up for you as of right now because it's not available on DokkanBattleBuilder.com. But let's see over here. If we open up his card and we open up, let's just say the tech cell, because they're both tech units. So just looking at it, he has what? Does he have revival? He doesn't have revival. He has messenger from the future. So that's, well, attack plus 500 kind of sucks. But he has big bad bosses, which is attack and defense plus 25% when HP drops below 80%, which is actually pretty cool. They both have Kamehameha, which is meh. They don't share Nightmare, and Ultimate Life Form is the other one. So the only thing they really actually share is Big Bad Bosses. So if this guy ever gets a Dokkenwake, it's not going to even matter because he's probably going to Shattering the Limit. So he actually doesn't link that well with him. But again, I will do a team building guide in the future when it's available. The next one is going to be the Demonic Shriek Boo Super. Now he gets a Dokkenwakening, so I'm not just going to talk about his leader ability, super ability, and passive. He was physical type, attack plus 50%. Super attack was extreme damage, lowers attack, and passive skill was recover 1000 HP for every key orb obtained. He's part of the Majin Buu Saga category, and he had a 12 key of 140%. He has a free-to-play farmable super attack, very similar to the Cell. You have to go into the actual Buu event. He Dokken Awakens from this Fat Buu, which is available from the Pure Destruction and Carnage event. You get him, Dokken Awaken him with three of the medals from the Destruction and Carnage event. Dokken Awakens into this Buu, then you can feed it into this guy. This guy will then Dokken Awaken with seven of the World Tournament medals into the Steady Advance of Evil Buu Super. His leader ability is physical type key plus two, HP attack and defense plus 70%. That's actually really good, especially for you newer players who don't have any good physical leaders for older events. Even the 70% events, this can come in very, very handy. Super attack is assault range, supreme damage to the enemy and lowers attack. Passive skill is abnormal vitality. Attack and defense plus 10% and recovers 5,000 HP per key orb obtained. That's actually really phenomenal. He actually becomes a really good unit. I mean, granted, if you're doing like a 120 or higher team, that 5,000 flat out buff or flat out HP recovery isn't that great, but he can definitely do some damage. If you get 10 or more key orbs, he's hitting for at least 100% attack damage more. And he gets a 100% attack buff for 10 key orbs. I mean, typically you only get about 6 to 7, but still. Link skills are Majin, Brutal Beatdown, The Innocence, Metamorphosis, Infinite Regeneration, Wall Standing Tall, and Shattering the Limit. So again, Majin Buu team. He won't do as well on a mono-physical hero team unless you're like linking him up with the Fat Buu. There is the Fat Kid, the actual Kid Buu as well. But that's for a different story. We'll do a team building guide when it's available. His new max stats are HP of 10,200, attack of 7132, and defense of 5258. Actually, not that bad. Standard higher defense for physical units. The attack's kind of low, but he is a nuker, so you can actually get him to hit very hard, especially if you get key orb manipulators. 12 key multiplier is still 140%. Overall, I think he's a cool unit. I'm happy I do have him. I think I have so many of him. I have all four dupe pads unlocked. So I don't think I'll ever use dupe system on him myself, but he's a pretty cool unit. I wouldn't mind using him. The next one is going to be the old school, an exciting adventure Goku Youth. This guy, his leader abilities, look how antiquated this is. Attack plus 25% for all types. Wow, that's old. Super attack Kamehameha, extreme damage to the enemy, passive skill, a good run. Attack plus 70% when three or more enemies. So useless. Let's see over here. 12 key multiplier, 132%. Wow, that's old. He now Dokken Awakens, actually, with 7 medals, so that's good. Actually, he is also farmable from this event. This is the Adventure of Gratitude. You can actually farm out the super the Goku Youth card. I think I did that on the global side. I got him up to Super Attack 10 doing that. So he's currently at Super Attack 10. When you do that, go ahead, get him all the way up to Super Attack 10, get him up Dokken Awakens. Now he Dokken Awakens into the Never-Ending Challenge Goku Youth. New leader abilities, all types, key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 50%. Super attack Kamehameha, supreme damage to the enemy, finally goes from extreme to supreme, which is awesome. Strong charge, attack and defense plus 80%. Wow, that is so awesome. Plus, an additional attack plus 80% and defense plus 40% when facing two or more enemies. So he's almost never going to have that come into play, but at least at some point in certain aspects of Dokken events, like let's say for the Cell event when you're going up against Cell Juniors, that might come into handy for you, or if you're just taking them along for fun when you're going up along the any type of story mode event where you have multiple enemies, that'll come in handy. Plus, he's part of categories Low Class Warrior, World Tournament, and Pure Saiyans. There's going to be aspects where you're going to use the World Tournament and Low Class Warrior as a buff to get additional drops. So that's going to be coming really handy because there's a lot of those story events that do that. Can have two or more people in the actual event. Link skills are All in the Family, Turtle School, Kamehameha, The Incredible Adventure, Guidance of the Dragon Balls, and Shattering the Limit. Categories, as stated earlier, Low Class Warrior, World Tournament, and Pure Saiyans. New max stats are going to be HP of 10,756, attack of 7,540, and defense of 4,794. He has a 12-key multiplier of 140%. So overall, he's a pretty good unit. Again, I can't do a linking guide right now because it's not available on Dokkan Battle Builder, but I did want to apologize for not doing a full in-depth review of all these new units from the World Tournament. So guys, on Global, if you have this guy, don't bother him just because he stunk at before you Dokkan Awakened him. Now he's actually pretty damn good. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. That's the overview of the JP Side World Tournament. If you guys didn't check it out already, I also released the video earlier today of the new data download. I think it was like the 3.15 or something like that. So go ahead, check out that video if you're interested to know what new stuff has been added to Dokkan Battle. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today, and I'll catch you all later. Peace.